Stress, oh my God. It's everywhere, from work to uni, psychological to physical, trauma, surgery, illness, and even exercise, and that scary movie that you watched last night. Feeling a bit stressed is normal, it's human, and when you're stressed, you tend to release a number of hormones, and if you're attacked by a lion, that's pretty helpful. But sometimes stress can be a bit much. It can bubble under the surface or be a cloud above your head, or it can be something obvious that you just can't do anything about. It can impact your hormones in a more chronic way, which in turn can make you feel not quite yourself. And you can measure your stress hormones. So let me tell you about that. So like I said, stress tends to cause secretion of hormones, which lead to a mobilization of energy sources to get you through a stressful situation, a bit like a fire alarm. In fact, you can learn about some of those stress hormones like adrenaline by checking out this award-winning beta blocker blockbuster video. A lot of stress hormones aren't around long enough for us to measure properly. They act fast and then they're gone. But there are a few which you can check. A problem we have though is that people respond to stress in a myriad of different ways, and that's to do with your genetics, your life experience, and your personality. No two people are the same, and it's difficult to draw an obvious box around people's response to stress. Instead, I'll give you a general overview so that next time you think something's not quite right, you might know a few things you can do to help yourself feel a bit better. In the world of stress, your symptoms can lead to easy to do, but not amazingly reliable tests, which can lead to hard to do, but far more reliable diagnostic tests. The key areas for stress hormone release are your brain, your thyroid, and in a big way, your adrenal glands, which sit above your kidneys. The stress hormone which most people talk about when it comes to accessible at-home tests is cortisol. When you get stressed, your brain stimulates your adrenal glands to produce a steroid hormone. Some people postulate that chronically slightly elevated cortisol levels is an indicator of chronic stress that can impact your livelihood. So seeing constantly slightly raised cortisol levels can be an indication that you need to do something about your day-to-day stress levels, either at work or at home. I say slightly because when levels are very high, it's more likely to be an indicator of a medical condition called Cushing's, where you can't stop producing cortisol. I'll touch on that one in a minute. Other stress hormones include your fight or flight big hitters, adrenaline and noradrenaline, which have an immediate impact on your heart rate and blood pressure. DHEA-S, and I'm not going to pronounce that one, which is a marker for adrenal function. ACTH, which is produced in the brain and actually causes the release of cortisol, so again, we'll talk about that one in a second. And your thyroid hormones, which are not necessarily specific to stress, but can tie into the whole picture. Check out that video up there if you want to learn about that. There's a few really important things to know though. Although blood tests, or in the case of cortisol, saliva tests, can provide valuable information, as I've already said, stress is very complex. A single blood test is not going to be diagnostic of anything and should really be interpreted with your doctor in conjunction with your symptoms. It's also worth noting that stress hormones fluctuate heavily over the day, so timing is important. I told you I'd talk about Cushing syndrome, also known as hypercortisolism. This is characterized by excessive cortisol levels in your body, which leads to symptoms like weight gain, a round face, easy bruising, muscle weakness, and a change in mood. There are some specific signs like thinning of the skin or stretch marks and fatty deposits, particularly on the upper back, leading to a bit of a hump. First, you test your cortisol levels at various points over the day. If it is particularly high at nighttime, that leads us to do some other tests which probably have to be done by a specialist. We can then look at your ACTH, which lets us differentiate between different types of Cushing's. Low levels suggest adrenal dysfunction, that's called Cushing's syndrome. High levels suggest there's an issue with the glands in your brain, and that's called Cushing's disease. Doctors can then do what is known as a dexamethasone suppression test, which should suppress your cortisol. If it doesn't, again, that suggests Cushing's syndrome. These are complex tests which do need to be performed by specialists. Addison's disease is like the opposite of Cushing's. It's adrenal insufficiency. Again, it starts with low cortisol levels, especially in the morning. This can lead to symptoms of fatigue and weakness, weight loss, darkening of the skin, and salt cravings. Again, cortisol and ACTH tests are the most important ones, but this disease tends to be tied to salt wasting, so additional tests might look at your kidney function and two other hormones involved in your electrolyte imbalance called renin and aldosterone. Again, you'll need a specialist at this point. Back to stress then. If you think you have a problem with stress, you can check your cortisol. If it's very high or very low, then you probably should see your doctor straight away. But if it's a little bit high or a little bit low, then you may well have a not insignificant stress problem and you can do something about that. Unfortunately, there's no magic pill for high stress levels. Instead, you have to think about things you can do in your life to modify it. From thinking about your work-life balance, to exercise, to diet, and it also might help to talk to friends or family or a counsellor about things. And it goes without saying that if you think your stress is leading you to feel very depressed or anxious, then you should always see your GP or family doctor. Anyway, hopefully this video hasn't made you feel too stressed itself, though I do get stressed if you don't subscribe. So come on, help me stay healthy here, reduce my stress, subscribe, ring the bell. See you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.